I think the basic assumption underneath SMS goes across the board, and that is the move from ad hoc safety management to more systematic safety management. And that works for operators large and small, undeniably. And so if we want to prevent accidents, we have to broaden our focus to include the entire system surrounding people at work. Right, this is where the so-called Swiss cheese model comes from, with the various layers and the holes in them. And SMS, in part, is a system that helps us look for those holes and close them before they can contribute to real trouble. Now, to avoid the problem of SMS becoming a self-referential system that just exists for itself, it gathers the data and it holds the data, is to be, well, creative in how we think about it. You know, the easy thing to say would be, oh, if you put garbage in, you get garbage out. But I think it's even more innocuous than that. I think you put garbage in, garbage stays in, and nothing comes out, right? Just more data. That in itself is probably not very useful. One of the things that we should probably think about is if the data that we've gathered doesn't give us interesting, actionable intelligence to do something with in our organizations, we should think about slicing the data differently, looking for other correlations that we may not have explored previously. We may leave this to luck, just start, you know, do some gaming and see how particular data correlates with other data, in which we can discover really interesting trends that may have otherwise remained hidden in this huge conglomerate of data that we have gathered. So slicing data differently, searching for different correlations, may reveal trends that we would not otherwise be aware of. When we look at smaller organizations, as these expectations flow out to smaller maintenance or flight operations organizations as well, I think it's to be maximally open-minded about what counts as systemizing, what counts as relevant data. Because these small organizations may have all kinds of interesting ways already in which they assure that feedback flows through the system, that the boss is allowed to hear bad news, that the boss actually is looking for bad news. And the ways that SMS may impose on them don't fit with that at all, right? So be maximally, again, inquisitive and open-minded about bottom-up ways of how people could systematize some of their safety practices they already have. And I think the other thing to watch for in this is one of the risks with safety management systems is that rather than the smaller operators being convinced that they're safe because they have the right know-how and the right experience and expertise in-house because they've been doing this for the last 40 years, they now have to convince the regulator that they're safe because they have particular paperwork and computer systems that they have, right? So how did they know that they were safe before? Well, they had the right people and the right expertise and experience, so we're safe. Look, CASA, here's what we have, right? How do they have to show you that they're safe tomorrow? Oh, we have the paperwork to show you, right? That, I think, becomes a dangerous bastardization of both the philosophy and the intention of SMS. SMS is not about show us the paperwork, not the practice. SMS is about let's systematize and organize the common sense that you already have and how can we help. McDonaldization refers to making the customer do the work. It has a couple of really interesting and I think constructive components to it. One is that it implies very strongly a joint commitment between regulator and operator. That the regulator isn't just the only one saying, oh, safety is important, you know. No, the operator itself becomes aware. It implies a mutuality and a discussion between operator and regulator that may not have existed before. Perhaps the operator comes with ideas and says, hey, if you want us to be safe, and if you want us to prove that we're safe or give you the confidence that we're safe, then this is really what we should be showing you. You shouldn't be asking for this nonsense because we don't think it contributes to your understanding of whether we're safe or not. This is what you should be looking at. So there may be a more reciprocity, a mutuality in the relationship between operator and regulator. And finally, and I think that's a very important contributor to the positive sides of McDonaldization, which is it implies trust. It implies the trust of continuity, that they're doing the right thing even if you're not there.